everyone. Welcome to Mirror Now. This is Property Hotline. I'm Kavita Krishnan and we're answering all your questions on buying, selling and investing in real estate today with Jayashree Kurup. Jayashree is the head of content and research at magicbricks.com. Jayashree, thank you very much for coming in.
Thank you, Kavita.
Let's get started with this question that's coming from Amol Kakde. Amol says that he's interested in buying his first ready-to-move-in home in Mumbai. The area he's looking at is between Borivali and Kandivali. His budget is 1.3 to 1.5 crore. He'd prefer a 2BHK property with a terrace. A 2BHK with a terrace. Now, that's something that's very difficult to find in Mumbai. And that too in a 1.3 to 1.5 crore budget. But he's a first-time buyer, wants a ready-to-move-in flat. What would you recommend?
Kavita, when I look at the site, I think he should be able to get a 2BHK of about 800 to about 1200 square feet in Borivali West, 825 to 1150 square feet in Borivali East. Now, this is what is listed on the site. Remember that in addition to this, you will have an additional price of, the stamp duty, the registration and so on. So, you must factor that in as well. 1.2 to 1.6 crore 2BHK flats are available, and I think even in Kandivali he should be able to get at least listed properties are there. But I do see a lot of people are listing property values a little less than what they expect, just to draw your interest. So even though I can see listed properties, you'll have to actually connect with the consumer, with the sellers, to figure out whether that's the rate at which you can get. Whether these flats actually have a terrace, I'm a little doubtful, but in places like Borivali, I have seen that you can get properties with terraces. So what I do think is you should go to the website, check out what your options are, and then shortlist the properties and do scrupulous tests, which means that you must check that all the property papers are in order, that all the approvals are in place, there is no dues left behind, because this is the secondary market and it is good to invest in a little bit of due diligence by a legal entity.
Right, so you're essentially telling him to look at both the secondary market and the primary market, both. The good thing, of course, is that you're looking to buy a ready-to-move-in flat, which means your risk is that much lesser. But that doesn't, of course, mean that you need not do any due diligence. That is very, very essential. Very quickly, Jayashree, this is a first-time home buyer. If you could just run through the necessary documents that he should be asking for and checking before buying that flat.
If you're buying from the primary markets, you must have the completion certificates, you must have the all the approvals must be in place, and you must have, the completion and occupancy certificates are two certificates that are a must, and many developers have been allowing consumers to come in and stay without the occupancy certificate. Now make sure that you do have those, because it is very essential, and especially in the new regime, the RERA regime that we are coming into, I think it is very important that you get all the papers in place. The approvals have to be documented. Even if you don't need a bank loan, I assume that most people do, it's good to go through the bank process, get a loan approved for a small sum so that the bank does the due diligence and you have that much of a safety net. I personally feel that if you're spending a crore and a half on property, it is worth spending 4,000-5,000 rupees to get all the property papers checked out by a legal entity.
Right, and it goes without saying, something that we keep repeating here on Mirror Now, if you are buying property, ensure that there is an agreement, that you sign the agreement, and of course, that you register it in your name. Deepak Joshi says that he's planning to book a flat at DS Max Tari in Shikari Palaya Road. This is near Wipro in Electronic City, Bengaluru, whose construction has just begun and completion date is April 2019. He wants to know, how is DS Max as a builder? Will they give possession within time? How about the neighborhood? Is it good to wait for 2 years till possession, or should he look at some other alternate property? What would you say?
I would say go ahead and check out DS Max, because we actually after we received this query, we went back to DS Max and said there is a consumers are worried about the possession, and the response we've got from the developers that their projects are all on schedule. They are giving in some projects they're giving it ahead of schedule, and they assured us that all their projects are going according to schedule and are not getting delayed. Now I would give them the benefit of the doubt for two reasons. One, from 1st May, RERA kicks in, and according to RERA, there are strict penalties for delays, unwarranted delays. Therefore, I think that the consumers will definitely feel more protected, and developers are definitely going to be more careful. The second is that this is a company, when we looked at the track record, they seem to be in the completion mode, and projects are getting completed. So I think there is no harm. The other thing is that you're buying into a locality where there is, it is on the Shikaripalya Road, and the rate there is about 4,000 to 4,800, and you're getting properties less than that. So I would say that you can go ahead, and since you're buying into a project that is under construction, a year or two from completion, it is all right. The project is underway, and you can go ahead.
Right, so there you go, Deepak. You asked about whether it's safe. You've not just got the answer to whether or not it is safe to buy into that property. You've also just got a status update from Jayashree over there. She's actually gone ahead and talked to the developer and tried to find out just where that project is at. Manish Vatyatil's question next. He says he purchased a flat at Marathon Next Zone, that is Gold Zone in Panvel, in July 2014. It is for purely for investment. What do you think is the future prospect in terms of growth of Panvel City? Will property prices be going up in the next 5 years? And what rental yield can he expect after possession is given in December 2018? He bought it for 6,216 rupees, including a floor rise of 33 rupees. What would you say, Jayashree? Panvel is not a market to be ignored right now.
No, I think there are lots of drivers, especially infrastructure drivers. You've got the airport, which is a big driver there, and hopefully that should be coming through. You've got the metro, the rail, the sea link. There are many drivers that if these projects all take off, the Panvel market is really hot. And I think Panvel is a standard fixture in our property show every time I do this show, I think. So clearly there is a lot of consumer interest, and there is a lot of development. Now, I would, in such early stage markets, I would actually caution the consumer. I think it is very important to do your own due diligence. Panvel is a huge area, very, very large area. There are some projects that are on the highway, and Panvel benefits from the fact that it is very extremely well connected both to Pune and Mumbai. But you must remember that there are some projects which are in completely off locations, and you have to actually go and check out the location of the project. Check out the prevailing property rates in that locality and see how the price of the property that you have chosen fits in there. You asked about the rental values. I think this is a early stage market, and it's not that you're going to get huge rental values. I think there is some amount of livability, but I don't think that you're going to get huge rental values. It's roughly about 6,500 to 15,000, depending on where the project is located. Now, your project is not complete. It needs to be completed. And by 2018, nobody can predict what the rental values will be. But I can tell you that going by the current trend, when the consumer does not buy, the rental values, there is a strong rental demand. But we expect that at least by the end of 2017 or early 2018, there will be a lot of demand for purchase. And whether rental values are going to zoom, I'm not sure. So it's like hedging a bet.
Right. Also, Jayashree, there are projects that are coming up in Panvel, if I'm not mistaken, which, and of course, those are the prices of Panvel over there for you, 5,633 rupees per square foot, down 4% in the last 1 year. But of course, that should inch up now that work on the airport is almost set to begin. New Panvel, 5,255 rupees per square foot over there. But coming back to the question I was asking you, Jayashree, we do hear of projects in Panvel where the developer is also building commercial, not just residential. Should he be looking at projects like that?
I would say retail investors should go for residential projects because residential has huge potential in the Panvel market. We did a study and found that when retail investors go into commercial investments, maybe shops and things like that, in new developing areas, the holding period is very high. So I would say that right now there is so much residential stock coming up. Do continue to invest in residential. But if there is a commercial driver nearby, that impacts the residential property prices positively. So it's a good idea to look into those integrated complexes where commercial and residential are both coming up.
Which is exactly what I was asking you. So you should, before you finalize on this particular project, also look for those projects which are integrated, which are multi-use projects, which are both commercial and residential coming up. You could get good rentals in properties like that going forward. Mukund Bhave says that he has a large residential property in a taluka having a 1 lakh population. This is in Akola, Maharashtra, namely Akot. Now he says it's spread over 9,000 square feet with built up area of over 4,000 square feet. It is in the prime central locality, overlooking a large stadium. Should he sell it?
You know, it's a very difficult question for me because it is not one of those frequently visited localities. But I can tell you one thing. We do have some a few listings of about 4,000 square feet. I think it is a 2 BHK house of about 4,000 square feet, which costs about 3 crore. I would use that as a benchmark so that you can figure out what the price is. But your property has another 5,000 square feet of, I think, land around it. So you will have to get it locally valued because I don't have such benchmark properties on the site. What I can tell you is that, you know, right now the markets are not very hot. Unless you need that money right now, I would say that, yes, there are listings. The market seems to be active and consumers are searching. I would suggest that you wait till RERA kicks in because that's when the amount of buying will pick up significantly. It's only another 2-3 months down the line. And in Maharashtra, of course, the RERA is almost ready. So I would say that wait for a little more time. Let the consumer sentiment pick up a little more and then think of selling your property. Since it's already, I can see listings happening, I expect this market to remain active.
Active market over there, Akola. But moving on, Animesh Chaudhary's question about Lodha Palava. He wants to know, would it be advisable to purchase a 3 or 2 BHK property over there?
You know, I bat for Lodha Palava for two reasons. One, when I visited it, what I found was that it is like a self-contained city and it is one of the smart cities of the country. It has 1, 2 and 3 BHK flats that are available, and 2 BHK flats are roughly about 60 to 66 lakh in Lodha Palava. Buying into a township, there are many advantages. One is that your schools, your hospitals, your entertainment centers, your sports complexes are all within touching distance. So you get a lot more time to use all these facilities. It also has commercial in the vicinity. So you will find that, it gives you, you have less traveling time. Also, it is extremely well connected through roads, and I think the road network is being augmented. So I would there is central security. There is I think maintenance is extremely well coordinated. So overall, I would bat for a property like this, and it shows in the 5% rise in property prices as well.
Right, and there you go. Properties over there priced around 6,314 rupees per square foot. But moving on to this question from Vishwas Gulati, who wants a 3 or 4 BHK apartment in the budget of 1 to 1.25 crore around the Dwarka Expressway for residential purpose. He wants possession in 1 to 1.5 years. What would you say?
You know, now I would say that look at the Dwarka Expressway, because I see a lot of projects. The expressway itself is moving to completion. There seems to be an intent to clear all the hurdles. And also there is a, developers have started, many developers have started actively completing projects. Do not go for, be very careful when you buy, because do not go for those properties which are where work has completely stopped. In Delhi, in Gurgaon, please look for the moving cranes. That is very important, because projects have been unreasonably delayed. And if developers have run out of money, even though the structure is already, you may not get possession of the property. So go for the ones where the cranes are moving. You will get a 3 BHK flat in 1 to 1.2 crore, and you will be buying from the secondary market, because a lot of these properties have already been sold, and you're buying from the resale market. So then all the things that we said earlier about checking the legality of the documents, that all dues are paid, that you're not, you don't have unexpected surprises, all that kicks in. So get the papers checked. If you're buying directly from the developer, and that is also possible because some developers have residual stock which they may sell to you right now, please make sure that you have a good, like Kavita said, there should be a sale deed, an agreement to sell, and you should have all your approvals in place, including the occupancy. Only then should you move into that property. Now, Dwarka Expressway comes in three phases. The ones that are sectors that are closest to Delhi, are the value are currently higher. In the sectors that are closer to Manesar, there is still, the sizes are bigger, so you may find that the net unit value is higher. The sectors between Manesar and, away from Delhi, are the ones where you will find it, find properties cheaper. The prices have not risen in the last 1 year. In fact, they have come down. But as the expressway work continues and as the project work continues, I expect this to rationalize and pick up in the second half of the year.
Right. Also, Jayashree, tell us this. Dwarka Expressway, should you be checking for utility connections, because that was a big issue some time back?
Yes, I think so. I think you must be going to the developer and checking out where the water is coming from, where how much power connections you have. And I think now that projects are actually getting completed, I see that there is a lot of intent to give the utilities as well. So I don't think it should be such a big problem, but do make the effort to check.
Right. Jayashree, next, Tarun wants to invest 1.3 crore rupees in Gurgaon. He's looking at under construction property and he's okay with possession by 2019. He's also, he says, looking at a furnished flat. What are the options available?
If you want furnished flats, there are three pockets in Gurgaon where you can pick up properties. One is the Golf Course Extension Road, where a lot of properties are coming to completion and people are actually furnishing or semi-furnishing the properties and then selling it. So you will be able to get some properties there. There is the Sona stretch, where the properties are going to be completed in another 2 to 3 years. And here you may there are some developers who are offering semi-furnished and furnished properties. And the third pocket where you can get properties is in Dwarka Expressway. The rest of these are the three new pockets. The rest of Gurgaon also, there is, you see, it's a very flat market. So if you negotiate, this is a market where you must negotiate. And if you negotiate, you might get reasonably good values. And 1 crore to about 1.3 crore, I think you should be able to get some options there.
And when he does negotiate, would you advise that he asks for, he negotiates so that he gets the white goods, the furnishings, etc., free of cost? Is that possible?
That's right. Kavita, there's no hard and fast rule. Most of the properties that are that go for sale in the Gurgaon market are not fully furnished. There are some people who want to exit their existing properties and upgrade. So they might be selling and they may not want to carry all their furniture with them. And I can see that there are some sales that happen where it is assist condition. It is plug and play. So you will have to scout around in the market. But if you put that requirement that you're looking for furnished properties, I think you can get furnished properties in even on our website.
Right, Tarun. So look at both the primary and the secondary market. We have Narayanan Kutty, who's called in from Pune now. How can we help you, Narayanan?
Good evening, madam.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Madam, I'm right now I'm calling from Pimpri, Pune. Madam, I booked a flat in Mantra Properties in 2015, madam.
Okay. And where is this project located?
Madam, this is in Moshi, Chakan Road, Moshi. It is in Chakan Road, and the builder is Mantra Properties.
Okay.
Madam, I have booked a flat at the rate of 3300 rupees per square feet, including floor rise, 100 rupees at 14th floor.
Okay. When did you book this?
2015, madam. May 2015, and I am expected to get the possession in December 2017, the same year.
Okay. What's your question, Narayanan?
And now my question is, madam, is this the wise decision to take a flat over there in this area, and what will be the appreciation value in coming year, and what will be the actually appreciation value, and what if I wish to go into rent, live it in the rent, what will be the rent in the future?
Right, Narayan, since you've already bought the flat, that's a decision that you've already made. But Jayashree will tell you about the Moshi market. How is it doing? Will he see appreciation over here? And what kind of rentals can he expect?
You know, he's booked into the property, into the Moshi market very early in its development. And I think that, I think he said he bought at 1700 per square foot, if I'm not mistaken.
100 rupees per square foot.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch that. What was that?
3,300 rupees per square foot in 2015.
Yeah, 3,300 rupees in 2015. And you have another year almost, about 7-8 months before completion. Right. The markets have been slow. But I think what will happen is that by end of 2017, we do expect the markets to pick up. And Moshi is a market where there is significant demand. So if at that point, if you think you want to exit the market, I suspect that you will get a buyer for your property. And I do expect some amount of appreciation there. It's not the most expensive market in the city, but it is a market where there is steady demand. The drivers, once the Make in India, Digitize India, these kind of projects kick off, I expect these markets to rise. Right now, I'm afraid I'm not connected. If Kavita, you could put up the Moshi values on prop worth, it would really help. But I think you don't need to worry about whether you've made the right decision, because you've bought early stages, and by completion, properties normally appreciate, and I think we've seen the worst of the market already passed.
Right. Jayashree, any economic drivers in the area? And if you could just tell us about the connectivity, etc. Is it close to any of the IT hubs in that sense? Will that get him good rentals?
Yes, I think so. It is not very far from the Hinjewadi hub. And you will, we do see people working in Hinjewadi looking for places like Moshi, because that is less expensive. I also see, Moshi is, I think, fairly well connected. I'm afraid since I'm not connected, I can't link in and tell you. But what I can say is that this is a area where both the IT and manufacturing sectors can work as drivers.
Right, so both IT and manufacturing sectors could work as drivers. So you can actually expect good, steady rental demand in Moshi, and the appreciation will kick in, like Jayashree said, once Make in India really takes off. Ram says that he wants to invest in a flat in Wagholi. Kindly suggest a builder. His budget is 60 lakh rupees. It is for residential purpose. 60 lakh rupees, what can that buy you in Wagholi?
You can get a 2 or 3 BHK in Wagholi. I've got both listed here. A 2 BHK is roughly about 1,000 to about 1,300 square feet. And a 3 BHK, you can get between about 11 to 1,300 square feet, or roughly about 1,400 square feet. And we have developers like Rohan, Suyog, Gagan. There are developers, not the A-grade developers, but a lot of developers who have had a track record of building in the city. So I think what you should do is check out the track record of the developer, check out their previous projects and see whether they have been delivering good quality projects. The best way to check out whether a project is good is to go into one of the earlier projects and see whether how satisfied the residents are. If there are large, seepage marks, if the maintenance is poor, don't go for those developers, because you know that once it's delivered to you, you are going to face a problem. But if on the other hand, you see satisfied consumers, you see occupancy, that those are the projects you should go for.
Right. And Jayashree, a lot of questions today on the Pune market. If you could just tell us what is your outlook on this specific market, because this is a place where prices didn't really run out of control when prices were going up in markets across the country. But you saw steady growth here.
There has been a steady growth. This market has never really crashed. And I think one of the good things that happened was, like you said, the prices did not run up. The developers did not turn greedy. Neither was it a investor-led market. I think most of the demand in Pune has come from either the local markets or those people who migrated to the city to work there. It could be the IT sector, it could be the manufacturing sector. And both these have had a good run in these markets. However, the prices did not go up exponentially. I expect the Pune market, and the amount of overhang in the Pune market is much less than many other cities. So I would say that this is a market that will steadily go ahead. And as the sentiment picks up, you will find, and sentiment as well as the jobs market pick up, you will see a lot of traction in this market. That explains the number of queries we're getting out of Pune.
Right, so market that is poised to grow, Pune over there, and Wagholi on the screen for you, 4,720 rupees per square foot is the average price in that particular market. Like you see, it's already inching up. And with that, of course, we come to an end of this episode of Property Hotline. Jayashree, thank you very much for coming in, answering all those questions. And any questions on real estate, send them in to us. We'll ensure you get answers from the country's biggest experts. Thank you for watching.